Greetings, 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 my brothers and greetings, my sisters. This is Brother Wes coming back to you again with another word of encouragement for those people who are in a time of trouble. You are in a time of trouble. You're in a difficult time. You're in a time of trial. You're in a time of test. You're in a trial where everything is testing everything in you. Life is testing your mind, testing your heart. And you're at a place where you're just crying out to God. You are crying out. And I want to say that for those of you who are crying out to God, you're in a good place, because the scripture says that God is nigh unto the broken heart. See, because when your heart is broken, oftentimes you cry. You might not cry outwardly, but inwardly you're crying. But also in that cry, when you call on him and when you belong to him, the scripture says, when the righteous cry, God is going to hear and deliver. And so in your cry, God is going to heal. And in your cry, God is going to deliver. Just know that God is going to fix whatever it is that needs to be fixed. And in your time of trouble, in your time of trouble, God is going to be a very present help. So in other words, in trouble, when you cry and when you call on him in your trouble, God is going to be there. He's going to be right next to you. He's going to be right near you to answer and also to protect, also to bless, also to comfort, also to supply. See, because God says that he'll supply all of our needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. So whatever your need is, God is going to supply it. Whatever you're asking God for, God is going to make it happen. God is going to give you what it is that you need to become that supply wherein you're satisfied. See, because the scripture says that the blessings of the Lord make you rich, and it will not add no sorrow to it. Is that all right? And in saying that, I just want to say briefly, just in a transparent moment. Now, you know, me and my wife, we move, right? And we moved into a place, and the place that we moved into, it wasn't big enough for my son, Daniel, to be able to stay with me. So now what we're doing, we're in the process of trying to find a place that's larger where Daniel could get back and be with us and stuff like. So keep us in your prayers, but also in keeping us in your prayers, if God has been speaking to your heart, if God is speaking to your heart to help us in any kind of way, we will truly and be grateful and appreciative for whatever you can give or sow into our ministry. Whatever God speak to you, if God has been speaking to you, if God ain't spoke to you, if God ain't spoke to you, don't be mad. Don't be mad. But if God has been speaking to you and you've been saying in your mind, you've been saying in your heart, well, I want to be a blessing. I just got to wait for this. I got to wait for that. And God has been speaking to you. Well, please, please, sir, please, ma'am, hear what God is saying. See, because your blessing also is in your obedience. Your blessing, when God speaks to you, it's going to come back. I promise you, whatever God speaks to you and you release it and you give it, it's going to come back, especially when you give unto a prophet. The scripture says, if you give to a prophet, you will receive a prophet's reward. And so, whatever you give, whatever God speaks to your heart, we're grateful. And you know, also it's hard times for everyone. And also, not only that, I as a result of just hard times, lost my insurance, so in the process of getting that back as well. So you know, just keep us in your prayers. And if God has been speaking to your heart, if God has been speaking to you, it's well appreciated. God bless you. I speak a blessing back to you. God bless you. Have a smile on you. And may all God's best be yours. Keep me in your prayers. God bless you.